Welcome to this week's edition of Grilling Stafford with Navasota City Manager Brad Stafford, along with the Navasota Examiner and Willie 98.7 FM.
All right, good morning, Navasota. How is everybody today?
Hey, we're good, Brad.
Just checking, see if they were still awake.
No.
Today, welcome to this edition of Grilling Stafford. I've lost the number. I don't know how many we have now. But with us today, we've got Anna Cassino from the Navasota Examiner and Kenny Graves, Willie 98.7.
Good morning.
Classic country.
Real country.
That's
real
right.
Country.
That's right.
Are you a friend of Willie?
I absolutely am.
Awesome.
I hope you are. I hope Anna is.
I am. Friend of Willie. Brad, we've got some interesting questions. Some are a little longer than others, but...
Well, you know me. I like real long questions.
Well, okay.
I give real short answers a lot of times for real long questions.
So the one that we start off with every week, can you tell us how many cases, COVID cases, we have in Navasota?
Oh, I was practicing the Carol Baskin question. How many cases? 76 in the county. We have 7 in our city. Still, as I tell you every week, I'm frustrated with the fact that we are unable to gain accurate information on how many of those cases have actually recovered, but also how many are actually in a hospital. We don't get that information, and I think it's a little bit misleading to not give that, but unfortunately, we're not able to access that information. So hopefully the state will hear some of our concerns. Mayor Miller did talk to Representative Lamont about that, and he promised that he would start working to try to get some better information to rural cities and rural counties to help us out.
All right, Brad, are there any programs around to help people unemployed due to COVID-19 find local employment?
I'm not real sure on finding local employment. You know, we do have the unemployment benefits that people can apply for. But as far as they could probably go to the Workforce Commission, and if there's any job openings, and I think you can look on the classified ads in the Navasota Examiner when I looked at it yesterday or last night. I saw some ads in there for employment. So anybody looking for a job, there's a couple of locations you can head out.
All right, Brad, what is TxDOT doing on Highway 6 between 3090 and the Navasota River Bridge?
They're resurfacing the roadway, actually between College Station and I believe all the way down to Hempstead, resurfacing that roadway.
Okay. We discussed this last week, but do we have a date when the recycling center here in Navasota will reopen?
We don't have a definite date. We had hoped that it would open this week, but we have not been notified by Republic Services that the MRF has reopened. I don't remember what that stands for, but that's what they call it, where they separate all of the recyclables. It has not reopened as of yet, so as soon as it opens, they're going to allow us to start opening up.
Brad, with Governor Abbott allowing more events to happen, what does Navasota have planned for our citizens?
We have a lot of fun planned for our citizens, and it's funny you ask, yeah, since you're a part of the plan. We do have a 4th of July celebration that we're working on, Independence Day celebration. We've always had it, or I say always, for many years we've had a parade and games and hot dogs for the kids and some fun, but this year we're going to go a little further. Madison and Raina and Anna and several of our local business people have gotten together and put together a great event for Independence Day. We're going to have a parade, but the parade's going to be reversed from previous 4th of July parades, Independence Day parades. We're going to go from the Navasota Center to downtown, finish up in our downtown. It begins at 11 a.m. And we've got some other surprises that are coming that we're still working on, but one we do have is live music. We're going to have some live music, local band playing, and some sales. So you need to get out and visit our local shops and find something good to buy. And just come out and support our locals, but also celebrate Independence Day.
For sure.
Looking forward to that after all we've been through.
I know.
Yeah, and hopefully if everybody will stay tuned, Madison's working and, well, I'll say Madison, the group along with Madison are working very diligently for some really cool added activities, but we can't announce those yet, so cliffhanger.
All right, Brad, I've asked this several times. Where are my goats?
Kenny, I don't know how many times I have to tell you. Don't tie your goat where everybody can see your goat. They'll get your goat every time. Kenny, we continue to make contact with the group and that owns them, the Rena Ruminant, and they must be really busy right now because they have not returned our phone call. Lupe actually tried to talk to them today, and we still have not received a phone call back. We do have an email out to them as well. As soon as I know, Willie will be the second to know. How is that?
I'll have it on the air. I'll be so.
But I've also been told that Connie has to know right away, too. So I guess you and Connie will be on a conference call with me.
Connie and I are very goat-centric.
Okay, Brad. So will the fourth Friday in downtown open this month?
May? No. We're not going to start in May of this month, but we will in, well, I say that.
Okay.
The city's portion of it will not open in May. If the businesses choose to do so, yes, it will be open. We won't be stopping them from doing anything like that. The city has plans for future Fourth Fridays to bring some live music in and just make it a little bit more of a fun day for everyone and a fun evening. And try to get more people out and support our local businesses.
Okay. All right. Is the new parking lot on schedule with all the rainfall?
It is on schedule. We should be finishing up within the next 2 weeks with that project. There will be a portion of Railroad Street will be left fenced in and unpaved as it's the connection to the next phase of this project. And so rather than pour concrete, and then break it out and start over. We told them it would be okay to leave it open and fenced off so that we could just carry on with a new project.
Okay. Brad, I got a really long one.
All right, let's hear it.
So there are several of us that live in Dove Crossing that are getting concerned about the wildlife and habitat due to the increase in people coming to fish and leaving their trash and fishing equipment. Several of us go down to the pond daily and pick up trash and throw away fishing line and hooks left behind. We have seen several ducks with fishing lines wrapped around their legs and necks. We have also witnessed several people find the nests that the ducks have and destroy the eggs. I have personally confronted two different families letting their kids throw the eggs from the nest and let them know that we, families that live in Dove Crossing, do not appreciate people destroying the nest. Is there anything that can be done to help remedy this situation? We understand it is a city-owned pond and love that families can get away to relax and get and have the opportunity to fish, but it is getting out of hand and we worry that the ducks and fish will not continue to reproduce for families to enjoy years down the road.
That is a long question, but it's a very good question. First off, whoever the questioner is, we really do appreciate the fact that they are good stewards of our community and are really trying to take care of the environment and the resources that we do have. I would say to the citizens, we do encourage you to utilize our parks, utilize Patu Pond for fishing and enjoying feeding the ducks, but be smart and take care of the resources that we have. Don't be mean and don't destroy nests. Pick up after yourself. That goes anywhere we are. When COVID started, people were dropping masks and everything. Mm-hmm. People need to take care of that. And that's, if they're true fishermen, I know a lot of true fishermen that always pick up more than they come in with. And that's what they should be doing. So if you're out there utilizing our parks and utilizing that pond, please be aware that you need to clean up after yourself and clean up after others if they haven't. One of our solutions to that is we will now make sure that the police department, they patrol it every day anyway, but the citizen if they witness any of this, should report it. If they see someone doing those things, you know, oftentimes confronting them yourself might not be a great idea. It depends on the situation. But you can always call the police department and they can help out. And we would be glad to help out. But we'll make sure and continue to patrol and ask that the citizens take care of our resources.
That was an A-plus answer. Brad, in the past year, there has been an increase in 18-wheeler traffic on Washington Avenue. The person who posted said, "I have seen as many as three at one time at LaSalle and Washington Avenue. Why are they not being ticketed?"
Well, they are being ticketed, and it may not be all of them, because it's difficult sometimes to be everywhere all the time. We have three officers on duty. If they have calls for service, they may not be available at the time a truck goes through. It just has to be timing. But I will tell you, they are receiving tickets if they're caught, and we try to do our best. We have conversations with trucking companies. The police department sets up and tries to intentionally run the truck route to avoid this, because it does damage a lot of our infrastructure as well. You know, how many times has the handrail at LaSalle and Washington been damaged by a truck making a right-hand turn? That costs taxpayer money. So we do take it serious. We do issue citations for those violators. But as I said, it's not that you can be everywhere all the time.
Doesn't some of our local businesses have big trucks that deliver stuff to them, so they have to obviously come through town to get
right.
to those?
You can't always assume that a truck is through traffic.
Right.
We have a lot of deliveries that are coming to our local businesses that are delivering. And, you know, police department, they work through that. Mm-hmm. They figure out, and some, you know, sometimes you may not know.
Right.
But that's just... It's one of those things, you know. Does everybody follow the speed limit on the highway?
Of course.
Yeah.
Of course we do.
I do too, Anna.
Okay, Brad. Anything on the new Super Walmart?
No. it's kind of funny. Lieutenant and I were just talking about that almost 15 years ago. When I took this job, I was told that we were going to have a new Super Walmart. So this all began before my time, and it may end after my time. I don't know. No, we have no news from Walmart, and not because we haven't tried. We've tried multiple times, and we get the same answer. Sounds kind of like a dial tone.
Okay, Brad, what are future plans for Spur 515, and do they include a bridge over the railroad tracks?
So the city has made numerous attempts and had numerous conversations with TxDOT regarding Spur 515 and a grade separation to make sure that our citizens, our emergency services, are able to access both sides of the railroad tracks if needed when a train is blocking the way. I would say yes, there is a plan. It's way down the road. TxDOT is fully aware. It has made a lot of lists, you know, and I know nobody likes the word lists, you know, it's on the list. But it is out there. It's in front of TxDOT. It's in front of other people to try to make sure that as money becomes available and the projects are released, that they'll be able to put some type of a bridge across those tracks to help us and help our citizens access back and forth, especially when a train is blocking the roadway. But I don't have any dates. I mean, it may be kind of like Super Walmart.
It's in the works.
It's in the works.
All right, Brad. Do the annexations in Pecan Lakes Estates change the city's ETJ? Do people in the ETJ pay city taxes or receive any city services?
So it does affect the ETJ. The ETJ stretches a mile past our city limits, so every time we annex, that adds to our ETJ. Generally, no, they do not receive services in the ETJ, and no, they do not pay taxes in the ETJ. They do not pay city taxes in the ETJ. ETJ stands for extraterritorial jurisdiction, in case people don't know. I get told a lot that I use a lot of acronyms, and then people are like, what is he talking about? But they do not, you know, we do respond to fire calls, and they already receive that service now. And there are times that police department, responds out there, especially in an emergency situation, our police department's going to respond along with Grimes County. But no, occasionally there are some locations where if a water main is in that vicinity that they would receive it. But normally we don't serve utilities unless they're in the city limit.
Did you have another one?
I do. I have one more question that was submitted to us. Brad, have you spoken to the prison officials and what procedures are being taken to confine the COVID cases within the prison system?
I don't really have an answer for that. I know that Chief Kitkoski is in constant contact with the prison and both prisons just to make sure that things are safe. And I know that we did have, St. Joseph did bring another ambulance into town just to respond to calls out there so that we didn't have an issue with any of our citizens. And I know that the state of Texas is doing all they can to control any COVID outbreaks in the prison system.
All right, Ed.
I think we've got the last question.
Yeah, I got a burning question I just have to have an answer for, Brad.
All right. Should we call Jason?
You might need to. Have you yet created your Facebook avatar? And if not, can Anna help create it?
Oh, yes.
He has no
can
idea.
Can I answer no and no to both of those? I have seen the avatars, and I'm afraid of what Anna would do
Brad,
to me.
It would be so much fun.
But no, I don't have an avatar. I'm not a real avid Facebook guy, so.
All right.
But I think that my avatar would probably resemble, I don't know, Arnold Schwarzenegger or something like that.
And one other thing.
I'll be back.
Got a great weekend coming up, other than chances for rain, but happy Memorial Day, and remember the reason we celebrate that.
That's right. Absolutely. That's right. We hope everybody has a happy and a safe Memorial Day, and as Kenny said, remember why we're celebrating Memorial Day.
Yep.
All right, next week, we'll be back. Same bat time, same bat channel. Hope to see you there.
See you later.
Be careful.